If you are thinking of culturing isopods, you probably already know that they are cultured both as vivarium janitors and as supplemental food for herps, such as dart frogs and geckos, as well as for invertebrates. The basic care requirements for all terrestrial species are essentially the same, but each species has some specific characteristics. Knowing these characteristics can help you decide which species is best for a specific application. This video will first cover specific information about dwarf or micro white woodlice, and then provide general culture information. Dwarf white woodlice, also known as micro white isopods, as well as other names, is scientifically called Trichorhina tomentosa. This species may be the most widely cultured species of isopod. They are quite adaptable, and thus are frequently used for a variety of reptile, amphibian, and invertebrate enclosures. Slightly larger than the Costa Rican micropod, dwarf whites are one of the smaller isopods available. Here is a size comparison with several other commonly cultured species. Their diminutive size makes them a good choice for tank janitors in a vivarium where larger isopods would be seen and eaten by the inhabitants. On the other hand, their size also makes them a good choice as supplemental food for very small animals such as dart frogs or juvenile geckos. In my experience, the dwarf white isopod, while definitely an omnivore, tends to be the most interested in meaty foods of all the species I have kept. It seems to eat protein-rich fish food pellets more quickly than the other species, and appears to have less of an appetite for oak and maple leaves. It will, however, eat fruit, such as banana or orange, and vegetables. Trichorhina tomentosa is a tropical species. They will survive at room temperature, and will even breed in the low 70s Fahrenheit, but they will breed much more prolifically at higher temperatures, such as the low to mid 80s Fahrenheit. They also appreciate quite moist conditions, perhaps more so than some other isopods, such as the giant or Spanish orange. Dwarf whites are parthenogenic. In other words, the females give birth to more females without the need to mate. Since every individual can produce young, these isopods tend to be quite prolific. They can also establish thriving populations where they weren't intentionally placed. In fact, I obtained my original stock as hitchhikers that appeared in my orange isopod and springtail cultures. Many isopods run immediately when they are uncovered or disturbed. Trichorhina tomentosa, especially adults, will often play dead for a short time before trying to escape. This may make them slightly less attractive to predators when they are first introduced into a vivarium. However, after a minute or two, they will become active again. All isopods spend much of their time hiding under leaves or pieces of wood. More than most other isopods, dwarf whites also tend to bury themselves in the substrate. This habit may help maintain a healthy population of isopods in a vivarium populated with animals that prey. General isopod culture information. Supplies. You will need a culture container. A variety of containers will work well, depending on the size of your starter culture. A 16-ounce deli cup is a good size for 20 or fewer individuals. The smaller container will help ensure that the isopods can find food and each other easily. If you start with more isopods initially, or once you have a thriving breeding population of isopods, use a larger container such as this one. An inch or two of coir fiber, also known as coconut fiber, or similar substrate. A top layer of substrate. I like to use non-toxic dry fallen leaves. Optionally, you can also add bark and small pieces of wood. Oak and or maple are suitable for leaves and wood. Take care to avoid leaves and wood that have been exposed to pesticides. Prior to use, all leaves and wood should be baked at 200 Fahrenheit to avoid contamination with pest organisms. Dechlorinated distilled or RO water. A calcium source, such as pieces of cuttle bone. A starter culture. Setup. You may choose to ventilate the lid. If you do, it is a good idea to stuff the holes with filter floss or similar material to prevent entry of small flying pests, such as fungus gnats, or forage flies. If you prefer, you can leave the lid unventilated as long as you remove the lid daily, or almost daily, to add food and water. This periodic ventilation will provide sufficient fresh air. First, add the base layer of coir fiber to the container. If needed, add water until it is moist but not soggy. When you squeeze it, some water should come out, but there shouldn't be any standing water on the bottom of the container. Then put in the dry leaves, bark, and wood. Add the cuttle bone. Give the contents of the container a good misting. Add your starter isopods. Maintenance. To maintain the humidity that isopods require, mist one side of the culture every other day, or more frequently if needed. It is a good idea to keep the other side of the culture slightly drier, as it allows the isopods to self-regulate their moisture needs. Though the isopods will eat the leaves, bark, and wood in the culture, they will also benefit from small amounts of a variety of vegetables and fruit, such as this piece of cooked squash, as well as high-protein foods, like fish food pellets. Feed small amounts at first and remove anything that becomes moldy. Replace one half of the substrate about twice per year or as needed. As some isopods will be present in the substrate you remove, you can use the old substrate to seed another culture. Harvesting. Isopods will congregate on pieces of wood, bark, or even cardboard, particularly if they are stacked in layers to provide plenty of crevices. These can then be lifted out, and the isopods can be brushed or gently shaken into a waiting container. Add them directly to your vivarium. Some isopods may be eaten immediately, but others will survive and breed in your vivarium. To maintain a healthy population, it is a good idea to add a quantity of isopods from the culture container to the vivarium periodically.